the military, that is arms and ammunition. It is also strengthening the society to have a social intelligence, some sort of care and awareness about the society. If they are bothering about their own bread, education, etc., then we make a weaker society. Weaker society is very easily attackable by any enemy, irrespective of the military strength. So one must understand that we must strengthen also the physical structure, the infrastructure, mental structure and intellectual network of the people, along with which a corollary, a collateral and coherent military strengthening process will come for our rescue. If we are not doing this thing immediately, it is not going to solve our problem in the long run systems. So technology, we are seeing lot of things. One, if there is any security in the form of code preservation, we are having cryptography. Cryptography, now you have invented cryptography. Kleptography, it has come. What is cryptography? I will write in such a language so that you cannot just understand it. So unintelligible scripting is known as cryptography, and decoding anything and stealing information is known as kleptography. You are having information security. They have developed info virology. How to totally petrify, how to totally make your things totally useless by means of a virus infection. So invasion by means of information errors in the form of virus that will totally make you inactive, or it may give you some type of, that is what we call apacheda or apanayana or diversion in English. So information codes, they can give you three things. One, you cannot get the information decoded, that is cryptoviral in nature. Second thing, you will get some other information which is boosted and overwritten by unwanted people, due to which you will get a wrong message, you will get an improper guidance. That is known as overscripting or overwriting, which is known as apanayana in Panchatantra. In even our rulings of the yesteryears, they used to do something, the same thing that happened in the British Empire at the time of Second World War. They wrote a letter in a dead body and made the person to go into the Nazis' rule at Poland. Immediately that was read, and people, those who are having their camp at Georgia, they have been totally misled. Instead of thinking that the people are going to invade that place, they have been misled to some other area near Argentina, and they vacated their camps and they went there. Immediately the British army went inside by intelligence. So this type of apanayana, that is what we call, whenever there is a message, that message must be urjita, nishchiti, prakriya. That is what we call in our ancient this thing, verification, cross-verification and ascertainization. So all of these things are to be organized for any information. Now we are having kleptography, in which they can steal your codes, they can erode your codes, and they can erase and rewrite some other codes which may just mislead you to a pathway of danger, or pathway of total energy loss, or pathway of total military power loss. So just type of mystifying, confusing and misleading forces are there in the society. Technology is not a proper combat. Whenever you invent one technology, immediately some other technology, counter technology is invented. Regarding technology, there are three things I want to say. One is the combat of technology. Whenever you invent something, you must understand two points, that the same thing is available with your counter forces, or even hyper technique or hypervalent techniques may be available with them. How it is possible? Because of clandestine support and technology. What is clandestine support and technology? If they are developing their own technology, that is known as technology. You know, for example, there is Pakistan. Pakistan has very, very limited technical resources. But Pakistan is clandestinely supported by powers like China and America. And also, very obviously, they are supported transparently in the pretext of science and technology development, infrastructure development, in the pretext of industrial development. They are supported with lot of technologies from other hyperend sources, because it is known as a double game. It is known as a bilateral game or bilateral diplomacy, in which somebody is prevented by lips or supported by the heart. The same thing is the diplomatic activity which is being done by lot of people. So technology means there is a technical combat. Whatever you do, immediately there are people doing the same thing or more than that, number one. Second thing is technological insufficiency. In this Bombay blast, everybody said that the terrorists, they brought the latest weapons, and we were having the same thing which we had before one or two decades. So technical insufficiency. Even we have seen lot of people now, we have seen police vans and jeeps. We are seeing in cinemas, I think that they would have painted it and decorated it nicely. Really, if you see the police vehicles or police arms and ammunition, this arsenal, totally that is outdated. you cannot use, or it will counter blast. Instead of shooting the opponent, it, due to some technical error, it may shoot the same police person also. So defective, obsolete, and totally imbecile system of operation has been given. Now also, 10 times it has been given by the Maharashtra Police Recruitment Board. 10 times they have given the report. Now also they have given twice. Even after the bomb blast at Mumbai, they have given it twice for renewal of, or for the sophistication of police resources they have given, and no steps have been taken. So technological means remote viewing, spying, spy coding, decoding, unmanned aircraft. There are innumerable things like that. There is International Space Station, number one. And there is satellite communication, number two. It is for five things. One is for identification. Second is for monitoring. Third is for verification. Fourth is for transmission. Fifth is for prevention, decoding, and processing. So these things are the five limbs or pancha bhutas of technology of defense and security. So they have to identify things. What is that? They have to identify. For identification of, a lot of things are there. Bomb identification, explosive identification, personal identification, infrastructure identification is there. Identification is also of three types. One is material placement identification. Second is remote identification. Third is personal or imaginary identification. So in image identification also, there are two types. One is image processing identification. Second is image placement identification. Image processing is also of three types. One is constructive image processing. Second is building or stability image processing. Third thing is subjective image processing. So by this methodology, now also if you just give the personal external structure or outline of a person, immediately they can infer, they can draw, they can process the figure of a person. So by means of imagination, by means of narration, by means of observation, by means of repetitive narration and experience, we can infer the persons, we can infer the components, we can infer the constitution of beings. Everything can be done. The same thing is done by a personal test subjected to experimentation, that is infinite viewing or immediate viewing. The same thing is done by a radar, satellite, or remote sensing, that is known as remote viewing. These things are very much existing here. So technological insufficiency is for people. Apart from it, that which really makes the technology really something capacious, something productive, is the intelligence of people. There are two things, like bride and bridegroom, intelligence and technology. It is a perfect mate for each other. If these two things travel at a particular area with mutual amicability and mutual affinity, then only the country can be protected. What is intelligence? Intelligence has nine instincts as per the Shastras and also by the present trends. Number one, intelligence is the power to suspect, to assume, and to spy. These things are the first stage of the level of intelligence. You have to suspect everything, you have to spy everything, and you have to assume everything. You must not say that I did not expect that foreigners to come and attack. You must assume, na? Will they be sending any letter or marriage invitation like thing to you? You must assume that there may be something because of so many reasons. One, if there is, there are three things also. It requires a different seminar which we are going to do on 8th, the national security discussion we are going to make. Number one, which is impact. If there is something happening in any part of the world for which India is a spectator, or India is an organizer, or India is a substratum, immediately we can assume, oh, Babri Masjid, they are saying that it is Babri.